गुरवे गौरचंद्राय राधिकाय सदाय कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय तद्भक्ताय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद गौरवंद बोलो हरे कृष्ण
हरे कृष्ण कृष्ण कृष्ण
हरे राम हरे
राम हरे
कृष्ण गाते गाते हिंदी वासी है ना मतलब होता है रमन से रेमुना है रमन मतलब सुंदर सुंदर से हम कहते बड़ा रमणीय स्थान है कहता ये बड़े सुंदर स्थान बड़े रमणीय स्थान है इसलिए रमणीय से ये स्थान का नाम पड़ा रेमुना रमणीय इसलिए कहते भगवान रामचंद्र जब वो वनवास हो गए वनवास
जब
रामचंद्र वनवास समय में यहाँ पर 4 दिन रामचंद्र यहाँ पर वनवास में रुके हुए थे इसलिए बड़ा सुंदर मनोरम स्थान था इसलिए 4 दिन ये राम लक्ष्मण सीता जी का रहने का स्थान है। हरि बोल रसिया सीता उनका मिली है
तो बाय द मर्सी व्हाइल डूइंग द परिक्रमा ऑफ श्री नवदीप धाम एंड नाउ क्षेत्र मंडल वी हैव कम टू दिस प्लेस इज नोन एज रेमुना द वर्ड रेमुना एक्चुअली कम्स फ्रॉम द वर्ड रमणा Ramana means very beautiful.
Yes, Yamuna.
So, Remuna word comes from the word Ramana. Ramana means very beautiful. So when Lord Ramchandra and Sita Devi, they came here during 14 years of forest exile. So that time they stayed 4 days in this area.
इसलिए यहाँ पर रहते समय एक समय माता सीता की मन में ये इच्छा हुई मैं गंगा में स्नान करूंगी गंगा तो यहाँ है नहीं इतने में रामचंद्र अपना वो तो भगवान है भगवान मतलब होता है अकर तुम अन्यथा कर तुम जो सक्य थे से भगवान मतलब है को नहीं नहीं को जो है कर सकते वो भगवान है इसलिए हम अभी थोड़ी दूर जाएंगे उसने में रामचंद्र या धनुष उठाया और उन्हें 7 बार उन्हें बाण मारे तीर मारे तो गंगा 7 धारा में बहते हुए गंगा जी आई इसलिए वो एक नदी अभी जो 6 जो धारा है अभी लुप्त है केवल एक धारा देखने को मिलेगा जिसका नाम सप्तसरा नाम पड़ा उड़िया में जो तीर को कहते सर 7 बार उन्हें मारे थे 7 धारा में बहते हुए गंगा आई थी इसलिए उड़ीसा भाषा में उसका नाम सप्तसरा है यहीं पर माता सीता जी स्नान की थी हम भी जा कर के वहाँ पर केवल एक धारा पानी है हम भी थोड़ा आचमन वहाँ पर लेंगे
सो मदर सीता she had the desire to bathe in the Ganges river when she came here so as you know that Ganges doesn't flow anywhere nearby But Bhagavan he can make possible impossible impossible possible. Kartum akartum anyatha kartum. So therefore, Bhagavan what he did, he took arrow and strung it to the bow and he shot the arrow 7 times. He shot 7 arrows and he produced the Ganges river from the ground. So that river is now known as Saptasara. As you know in Odia language, the arrow is known as shara or sara so because he shot arrow 7 times and that river was produced so the river is called saptasara so now only one stream is flowing and we'll go and take achman there after some time
isliye sita devi snan karne ka baad unke man mein ye ichha hui hum shankar aur parvati ko darshan karna main chahti isliye kehte wahan par abhi bhi wahan par ek harchandi एक देवी का नाम है हरचंडी और शंकर जी है इसलिए यहाँ पर प्रकट हुए हम जाएंगे दर्शन करेंगे माता सीता स्नान करने के बाद जिनको दर्शन किया
सो आफ्टर दैट सीता देवी हैड द डिजायर दैट शी वांट्स टू टेक दर्शन ऑफ शंकर एंड पार्वती सो देयर बाय द डिजायर ऑफ लॉर्ड रामचंद्र बोथ ऑफ देम मैनिफेस्टेड एंड देयर मदर पार्वती इज प्रेजेंट एज Chandi and Lord Shiva is present as her. So both husband and wife, Shiva and Parvati are present there as her Chandi. We'll also go and take darshan of this foremost of the Vaishnavas.
Okay. कहते ये जो ठाकुर जी हैं, कहते ये ठाकुर जी प्रकट कैसे हुए? कहते जब राम लक्ष्मण सीता जब वनवास हो गया, वनवास होते समय आप लोग नाम सुने, पंचवटी नाम सुने, जहाँ पर बड़े बड़े पांच प्रसिद्ध था, जहाँ पर राम लक्ष्मण सीता जहाँ पंचवटी में जहाँ पर रुके थे, एक समय राम लक्ष्मण सीता बैठे हुए थे, रामचंद्र अक्षर करके जहाँ पर ऋषि मुनियों का आश्रम होता था वो आश्रम उनके पास में रुका करते थे। हठात आकाश में आंधी तूफान आ गया, आंधी तूफान आया तो आश्रम में जो गैया थे वो इधर उधर भागने लग गए, गैया भागने लगे तो उसको देख करके रामचंद्र मुस्कुरा रहे थे, पास में सीता जी बैठी हुई थी, बोले प्रभु आप मुस्कुरा क्यों रहे हो? तब रामचंद्र ने कहा देखो मेरे द्वापर युग का लीला मेरा स्मरण हो गया इसलिए मेरे को मुस्कुरा रहा हूँ। बोले इसका मतलब क्या? इसका मतलब है कहते द्वापर युग में मैं नंद के लाला बन कर आऊंगा, अभी तो दशरथ महाराज का लाला बना, उस समय नंद के लाला बन कर आऊंगा और मैं ग्वाला वंश में जो आएगा ग्वाला वंश में, और मेरे पिताजी का 9 लाख गैया होंगे और 9 लाख गैया को चराने के लिए जाऊंगा। उसी समय गैया एक जगह से गैया फिर रहेंगे इसलिए भागेंगे उस समय, इसलिए अभी ये लीला को देख करके वो लीला मेरा स्मरण हो रहे। ये अवतार में केवल एक सीता छोड़ करके दूसरे पत्र धारण नहीं करूँगा, लेकिन कृष्ण अवतार में तो राधा रानी एक तो मुख्य रहेगी, फिर 8 सखियाँ रहेगी और उसको साथ साथ में केवल 8 सखियाँ नहीं 1 करोड़ गोपियों को साथ में रास करूंगा और मेरे दाम वसुधाम श्रीधाम मधुमंगल को कृष्णा बहुत सखाए होंगे इनको साथ में गैया चराने के लिए जाऊंगा जंगल बन बन में, इसलिए वो लीला मेरा स्मरण हो उठा इसलिए मैं मुस्कुरा रहा हूँ। इसको सुन करके सीता के मन में इच्छा हो गई कि तो प्रभु आप मेरे को वो रूप थोड़ा दिखाओगे, चित्र अंकन करके दिखाओगे आपका रूप कैसे होएगा, भैया कैसे होएंगे, आपका गोपी कैसे होएंगे, सखा कैसे होएंगे, मेरे को थोड़ा दर्शन कराओगे? रामचंद्र ने कहा 7 दिन बाद में दिखाऊंगा। तब रामचंद्र गुफा को अंदर में गए और अपना हाथों से तीर में वो जो ठाकुर दर्शन कर रहे हैं एक शिला के ऊपर में तीर में उन्होंने तीर में वो ठाकुर उन्होंने बनाया।
Now how this deity manifested, it's a very beautiful and interesting history. Lord Ramchandra, when he was in the forest exile, he decided to stay in one place. There were 5 banyan trees there. So in Sanskrit, the banyan tree is known as Vata and Pancha means 5. So there was beautiful 5 banyan trees and in the vicinity of those 5 banyan trees, Ram, Lakshman and Sita were residing. And Ram, Lakshman and Sita used to take shelter near the hermitage of the sages. They used to also build a small hermitage for themselves and they used to stay there. So one time there was like a storm. And there was storm and wind was blowing and the sky was clouded. And at that time all the cows became scared and they wanted to take shelter in their goshala. So that time all the cows started running to take shelter and Lord Ramchandra was smiling. Seeing the smile on the face of the Lord, Sita Devi inquired, "Oh Lord, how come you are smiling?" Then Lord Ramchandra told that in this particular millennium is known as Treta millennium. And in this millennium, I have become the son of Dasharath Maharaj. But in next millennium, I will come as the son of Shri Nanda Maharaj. And that will be the Dwapar Yuga. And that time, I will be a cowherd boy. And my only job will be to take care of the cows. So whenever it will rain, I will see the same sight again, that I will be taking cows to safe shelter when it's going to rain. And this particular incarnation, I will have only you as my wife. I will not accept any other woman as wife. But in next incarnation, when I will come in Dwapar Yuga as the son of Nanda Maharaj, I will have Srimati Radharani as my prominent beloved this thing, but consort. But then I will have 8 sakhis. And not only that, I will have 1 crore gopis and I will perform ras dance with them. Also, I will have so many beloved sakhas like Dam, Vasudam, Sto, Krishna, Bhringa, Kokil, and I will have so many cows and everything. So, hearing that, Sita Devi developed a desire. She told Lord Ramchandra, "Oh Lord Ram, please show me that form. I have a desire to see your sakhis. I want to see your beautiful form. I want to see your friends. I want to see your cows. How will they look? can you please show me them in the deity form? And Lord Ramchandra complied.
उसी समय रामचंद्र एक गुफा को अंदर में गए और वो जो शिला दर्शन किया ठाकुर जी को, एक पत्थर शिला में तीर से उन्होंने ठाकुर जी को बनाना शुरू किया। बोले 7 दिन बाद ही तुमको दर्शन कराया, अंकन करके केवल अभी 4 दिन हुआ। अभी सीता जी को मन में इतने उत्साह हो उठा, कैसे उनका रूप होगा द्वापर युग में, सखियाँ कैसे होंगे, गोप सखाएं कैसे होंगे, गैया कैसे होंगे, इतने उनका मन में इतना उत्साह होने लगा। आप सीता जी को मन में 4 दिन बाद में बोले प्रभु जी मेरा क्या बोलते हैं, मेरा उत्साह को मैं धैर्य धारण नहीं कर पा रहा हूँ, अभी मेरे को दिखाओ। लेकिन रामचंद्र इस तरह से वो जो मूर्ति को ऑलरेडी अंकन कर चुके थे, इतने में उस शिला को उन्होंने निकाल करके उन्होंने सीता जी को उन्होंने दर्शन कराया। सीता जी को दर्शन करके सीता जब दर्शन किया ये रूप को, बोले प्रभु आप में और इनमें तो कोई फर्क नहीं दिख रहा है, लेकिन थोड़ी सी फर्क भी है। बोले क्या? बोले आप तो पूरा सीधे साधे हो, लेकिन ये 3 जगह में टेढ़े लग रहा है, और आपको हाथ में धनुष है और इनके हाथ में बंसुरी है, और आपको जो आँख है ये गंभीर है, लेकिन इनके जो आँख है ना थोड़ा चंचल सा दिखता है। हाँ, और आपको हाथ में धनुष है, आपके हाथ में बंसुरी, केवल इतना ही फर्क दिख रहा है। फिर उनने सखाए सखियाँ और उनको सारे पियन और सखा, अब देखिएगा वो शिला के ऊपर में कृष्ण का जो चरण को नीचे वो सब बछड़े, और दोनों तरफ में 8 सखियाँ हैं, और ऊपर में चारों और मुष्टि, और ऊपर देखना इसे 3 पत्थर है, कहते गोविंद गोपीनाथ मदन मोहन, ये तीनों का प्रतीक वो है। अभी सीता जी को मन में बड़ी उत्कंठा हो उठी, मैं ये ठाकुर जी को मैं भी सेवा पूजा करूंगा।
सो आफ्टर दिस सीता देवी शी बिकेम वेरी ईगर। लॉर्ड रामचंद्र टोल्ड सीता देवी एब्सोल्युटली नो प्रॉब्लम, इट विल टेक मी 7 days टू कार दिस डीटी, and I will show you all this beautiful form of myself, my cows, gopis, sakhas and everything. It will take me 7 days, I should be left undisturbed. And he entered one cave and requested Sita Devi to give him 7 days and to be alone by himself. But after 4 days, Sita Devi could not control her eagerness. And she entered into the cave and she asked Lord Ramchandra to show the deity. So Lord Ramchandra showed her the deity, and it was very beautiful deity. And you can see, and seeing that deity, Sita was overwhelmed with love. She told Lord Ramchandra that there is absolutely no difference between this deity and you. You and this deity are very same. But I see some slight differences. One difference is that you are standing straight and this deity is crooked in 3 places, bent in 3 places. Another thing is that you are carrying bow and arrow in the hand while this deity is carrying flute. And your eyes are very much grave, but the eyes of this deity are restless, as if searching for something. So, in this way, this deity is surrounded by Krishna's Priyanam Sakhas, like Vasanta, Kokil and others, and Madhu Mangal. The deity is surrounded there, then small kals are also surrounding the deity. Also, Chanur and Mushtik are there on side of Krishna. And above Krishna there are 3 symbols, they represent our 3 deities, Govinda, Gopinath, Madan, Mohan, the deities of Gaudiya Sampradaya. In this way this deity is very beautifully adorned, and this deity was served by who? Then Sita Devi requested Lord Ramchandra that I would like to perform devotional service to this deity. And Lord Ramchandra permitted and she began to worship this deity. So you can see here the deity is carved by who? It is carved by Bhagwan himself. This is the only deity in the universe which is carved by Bhagwan. His own deity, Bhagwan has carved his own deity. And it was worshipped by Sita Devi, Bhagwan Swarup Shakti. So, it is explained that the deity is as important as the person who has worshipped it. So, the personality who has worshipped this deity is Sita Devi. So, Swarup Shakti of Bhagwan. So therefore this deity is most important. Generally in our house also we have deities. These deities are also important and not different from Bhagwan. But still we have come so far with so much trouble. Why? Because only to see this deity which is carved by Bhagwan himself. And also it is worshipped by Swarup Shakti. So therefore we come here, because this is the most important deity. Second thing is that this is very beautiful deity. And another thing, what happened, that after that, this Panchavati place, where five banyan trees were there, and later on, there was one great sage, Atri, and he requested Lord Ramchandra, there is lot, demons are causing lots of trouble, they are not letting us engaging any devotional service or fire sacrifices, they are disturbing our hermitages and causing so much violence. So Lord Ramchandra, he agreeing to the request of Atri Muni, he went to his hermitage, the Sita Devi, and kill all the demons and made his ashram free from any disturbance. So Sita Devi, who was performing the devotional service of this deity, was now away with Lord Ramchandra in Atri Muni's ashram. So therefore, Lord Brahmaji descended from Satyaloka and on his swan carrier and performed the devotional service and went back. So he regularly came here and performed the devotional service to this deity personally, and he went back. So in this way, this deity is also worshipped by Brahmaji, who is the Acharya for Sampradaya. So you can imagine the importance of this deity, because this deity is worshipped by greatest personalities, Sita Devi and Brahmaji. The question may arise, Panchavati happens to be in Maharashtra, in Nasik. So how can the deity come all the way from Maharashtra, the other corner of the western corner of India, to the eastern corner? So the mystery is revealed here by Sripad Sridhar Maharaj, that there was actually one king, and at the end of the Treta Yuga, this deity was established. And then when Dwapar Yuga came, this king, Langula Narsingha Dev, he went to Panchavati and he saw this deity. He went there with his wife. When he saw the deity, he was very attracted to the deity. And he didn't know that Brahmaji comes every day and performs devotional service to this deity. He said, oh, no one is performing devotional service to this deity, so I will take this deity to Orissa, to my kingdom. So then he carried this deity all the way from Maharashtra to this place, from Panchavati to this place, here. And when the deity came here, then deity saw that there were so many cowherd men were here, so many cows were here, plenty of milk, yogurt, butter, ghee, everything was here. And then Krishna became perfectly felt, this is my homeland, because this is like Vrindavan with so many cows. So then when the king wanted to take him further to his kingdom, that time the king wanted to take him to Jagannath Puri, but that time Thakurji told, no, I don't want to come to Jagannath Puri, this Remuna is fit for me. So therefore, this deity is here, and you can see here that very beautiful offering is made here. That is called Amrita Keli. This Amrita Keli is very condensed milk and very beautiful taste is there. And they put in that so many cashews and other dry food they put in, and it is served for the pleasure of the Lord. So previously, the name of this deity was Madan Gopal. Then it became Jai Gopal. But the wife of the king, she thought the appropriate name for the deity is Gopinath. So she renamed the deity as Gopinath. Since that day onwards, the deity is known as Gopinath. And this deity later on, for the sake of Madhavendra Puri, stole the kheer, one pot of kheer, and hid under his cloth. So since that day onwards, the deity is known as Kheera Chora Gopinath. Chora means a thief. One who stole the condensed milk kheer for Madhavendra Puri. So since that day onward, he is known as a thief. Actually, in this material world, if we address a thief as a thief, even the thief will become angry. No one likes to be addressed as a thief, although he may be a thief. But here, Bhagavan has taken the name thief, the thief of condensed milk, just for the sake of his devotee. And Bhagavan is not ashamed of it. Bhagavan is rather proud that, yes, I stole kheer, but for who? For my own devotee. So this shows that the Bhagavan's vatsalta or Bhagavan's mercy towards his own devotee.
अभी हम जहाँ पर माधवेंद्र ने भजन किया और जहाँ माधवेंद्र पुत्र का समाज आया है, जिसके लिए भगवान स्वयं खीर चुन किया, कभी साधारण भक्त नहीं होगा
आपके लिए, दो हाथ की चुन किया,
इसलिए तब उन्होंने सचमुच से जा करके देखा बात क्या सही है कि झूठ है, मंदिर खोल कर सचमुच से वो खीर।
Sometime after this, we'll go to the bhajan place, the place where Sri Madhavendra Puri did his bhajan. Sri Madhavendra Puri, as you know, that he is the sprout, the first sprout of the creeper of Prema. He is the Prema Ankur. So in this way, Sri Madhavendra Puri, he was on his way to Jagannath Puri. He was coming from Vrindavan, from Govardhan, to bring the sandalwood. And he was requested by Sri Gopal deity to bring the sandalwood and to make it into paste and apply all over his body. So taking the order of Gopal, Madhavendra Puri was on the mission to get sandalwood. So when he came to Remuna here, he took some rest here and he had darshan of Sri Gopinath ji. When he had darshan of the Gopinath ji, then he came to know that they offer one particular type of kheer or condensed milk that is called Amrita Keli. When he heard this name Amrita Keli, a desire arose in his heart. I want to know what are the ingredients of this kheer, what is the recipe of this kheer, how they prepare this kheer, so that I can also offer it to my Gopal deity in Govardhan. So that desire came in his heart, but then this kheer was not offered yet to Gopinath. So then he felt ashamed. Alas, alas, what type of desire came in my heart that I want to test the bhoga of the Lord even before it is offered to the Lord just by hearing its name. But actually his desire was to prepare it for the Lord also in Govardhan. So anyways, with being feeling little embarrassed, he went away and sat under a tree. So that time Bhagavan also reciprocates with the devotee. So the pujari came in a brought in a tray 12 earthen small pots like this, and he filled up to brim in them, and he offered to the Lord and he took away the tray. But that time Lord had taken one earthen pot and he had kept hidden under his cloth. Pujari, due to the influence of Yoga Maya, Bhagavan's mystic potency, could not realize that there were only 11 pots in the tray, and he took it away. Later on, when Pujari fell asleep, Bhagavan came in the dream and told the Pujari that I have kept one pot of sweet rice for Madhavendra Puri. A great devotee has come from Vrindavan. So therefore, this pot should be given to him. Then Pujari, he came out and he began to shout, "Where is Madhavendra Puri?" Came in the night, midnight he came out and he told, "Where is Madhavendra Puri? Lord has stolen kheer for you. He has hidden kheer for you." So that time Madhavendra Puri, all night he was chanting Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. He never slept. So Madhavendra Puri immediately came there. He was also overwhelmed and he immediately honored that kheer. But he was so much honored, so much ecstatic to honor that kheer, that he took that earthen pot, he broke into pieces, and every day he was taking little bit of that earthen pot as prasad of the Lord. So in this way, he became very ecstatic. Later on, everywhere the news spread that yes, Madhavendra Puri has been blessed by the Lord. The Lord stole kheer for him. When the news spread everywhere, Sri Madhavendra Puri is always, never wants any name, fame, adoration, prestige. Similarly, due to the fear of being overwhelmed by name, fame, adoration, prestige, he left for Jagannath Puri that same night. So no one in the village could come and offer him obeisances or anything.
यहाँ पर आप लोगों ने पीछे दर्शन किया होगा रसिकानंद प्रभु का भजन कुटीर और समाधि है ये रसिक
मंदिर ऑफ श्री रसिकानंद प्रभु. Sri Rasikananda Prabhu was the disciple of Sri Shyamananda Prabhu. And Sri Rasikananda Prabhu, as you know, he was incarnation of Sri Aniruddha. Bhagavan is manifest in quadruple expansion forms, Pradyumna Aniruddha Vasudeva Sankarshan. So one of the quadruple manifestation, Sri Aniruddha, is Sri Rasikananda Prabhu. He is also Bhagavat Tattva, is non-different from Bhagavan. And because he is non-different from Bhagavan, he is a great personality. One time, Sri Rasikananda Prabhu was performing Sankirtan here in the courtyard of this temple in the association of his disciples. That time he became very ecstatic and he started running towards the temple and he entered into the deity. And when he entered into the temple, the door closed and then he entered into the deity and he never came out of the deity. Because he is Bhagavan, So he actually entered into the deity. The great personalities like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Nityananda Prabhu, Advaita Acharya, because they are not different from Bhagavan, they are themselves Bhagavan. So no wonder they have no... So they can merge in the deity itself, because they are not different from the deity. But one cloth from his body fell on the ground, top cloth. And the disciples collected that cloth and gave samadhi to that cloth. So the samadhi we saw there, that is a cloth samadhi called Vastra Samadhi. Another small building here is the Bhajan Kutira of Sri Rasikananda Prabhu. So in this way, Sri Rasikananda Prabhu, actually he preached very strongly in Orissa. If you see any Gaudiya Vaishnavism in Orissa, it is due to the mercy of Sri Rasikananda Prabhu. Also, the Muslims were very much envious of him. So the Muslims, one time, they caught hold of one mad elephant. That elephant had become mad, insane. And that time, they released that elephant on Rasikananda Prabhu. And they wanted to see the potency of Rasikananda Prabhu. Therefore, he's a really good preacher, he's really strong spiritually, then he'll protect himself. So when that mad elephant came, Rasikananda Prabhu took water from his kamandalu and sprinkled on the elephant and chanted the mantra Hare Krishna. Immediately that elephant became quiet. And then Rasikananda Prabhu didn't stop there. He uttered the Gopal mantra in his right ear. And when he uttered the Gopal mantra in the right ear of that elephant, he became the devotee of Krishna after that. Because he got the Gopal mantra, he was given the name Gopal Das. Now this elephant was doing Annik three times and he was chanting Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, and he also used to go on preaching. Because you preach to the people like you, so he used to go to the forest and he used to collect fellow elephants, wild elephants, and he used to give them Harikatha and he used to bring them to Rasikananda Prabhu. So then all the elephants, hundreds and thousands of elephants used to come to Rasikananda Prabhu to get the Gopal mantra and initiation, and in this way all the elephants samaj became very strong in bhakti. So now we'll go to the... There are so many pastimes of Rasikananda Prabhu. We'll hear them later because now it's getting late.
Prabhu, abhi ek kheer hai.